gentlemen, the governor of Alaska and the next vice president of the United States, Sarah Palin.
McCain's vice presidential pick was a one-woman thunderbolt, instantly shattering the campaign narrative and panicking the news media. Desperate to destroy this woman from Alaska who dared to threaten their storyline, they crammed more vetting of her into a few days than they had during Obama's entire campaign, frantically lurching after stories that were both untrue and previously off-limits, including the baseless allegation that she had an affair with her husband's former business partner and the utterly asinine claim that her newborn child was not even hers, but rather belonged to her teenage daughter. Even when the press became obsessed with the fact that Palin's daughter was 5 months pregnant, making it physically impossible for that grotesque theory to even be remotely plausible, prominent liberal blogs still bathed in their sick fantasies. After her spectacular convention speech in front of a record TV audience, three former Hillary aides in the Obama campaign were quoted as saying, "This woman is trouble." It was immediately obvious that the media's first attempt to destroy Palin had backfired, but they instantly reloaded, with Brian Williams almost literally sounding the call for the cavalry to counterattack.
About the attacks on the media tonight, Joe Klein's on the board. His blog for Time magazine, and I'll quote briefly, "I hope my colleagues," meaning his colleagues in the news media, "stand strong in this case. It's important for the public to know Palin raised taxes as governor, supported the Bridge to Nowhere before she opposed it, pursued pork barrel projects as mayor, tried to ban books at the local library, and thinks the war in Iraq is, quote, a task from God. The attempts by the McCain campaign to bully us into not reporting such things are not only stupidly aggressive, but unprofessional in the extreme. Just another Wednesday night in Minnesota."
Wow.
The next morning on the same network, there was much revelation and a prescient prediction.
All of the journalists last night, they were being self-righteous, saying, "We will not be swayed by this woman from Alaska." You know what? They're pretending that the first 3 days of this week didn't happen. It did, and it was pathetic. I think I live it up in you. You and I both saw people behind the scenes this week foaming at the mouth.
I did.
Trying to chase down these lies on Daily Kos.
I thought it was disgusting.
You and I both saw people behind the scenes this week foaming at the mouth.
I did.
Trying to chase down these lies on Daily Kos.
I thought it was disgusting.
The media hates being proved wrong. Proven wrong.
Yeah.
They attacked her. People started saying she needed to get off the ticket. She delivered an amazing speech. You watch. They're really going to bear down now. They don't like being proven wrong. And Mike Barnicle, they're going to try to savage her.
When McCain Palin immediately rocketed to a lead in the polls, the wolves descended on Wasilla, Alaska to dig up more dirt on Palin. ABC's Charlie Gibson got the first crack at taking her down one-on-one, and he did his best to make sure he didn't disappoint his surely cheering colleagues.
Oh Lord, please don't let me be misunderstood.
My oldest, my son Track, he's a soldier in the United States Army now. He's an infantryman, and so Track sends his love also to his former nanny, Christy. And Track, pray for our military. He's going to be deployed in September to Iraq. Pray for our military men and women who are striving to do what is right also for this country, that our leaders, our national leaders, are sending them out on a task that is from God. That's what we have to make sure that we're praying for, that there is a plan and that plan is God's plan. So bless them with your prayers, your prayers of protection over our soldiers.
Well, I got nothing against the press. They wouldn't print it if it wasn't true.
finally tonight, a bit more of our conversation with Sarah Palin, our entire interview today about national security issues. I asked her about some comments she made regarding Iraq. The comments were made to the congregants of her former church.
You said recently in your old church, our national leaders are sending U.S. soldiers on a task that is from God.
Pray for our military men and women who are striving to do what is right also for this country, that our leaders, our national leaders, are sending them out on a task that is from God.
Are we fighting a holy war?
The reference there is a repeat of Abraham Lincoln's words when he said, first he suggested, never presume to know what God's will is. And I would never presume to know God's will or to speak God's words. But what Abraham Lincoln had said, and that's a repeat in my comments, was, let us not pray that God is on our side in a war or any other time, but let us pray that we are on God's side. That's what that comment was all about, Charlie. Today is the day that I send my firstborn, my son, my teenage son, overseas with his Striker Brigade, 4,000 other wonderful American men and women to fight for our country, for democracy, for our freedoms.
But you went on and said there is a plan, and it is God's plan.
I believe that there is a plan for this world, and that plan for this world is for good. I believe that there is great hope and great potential for every country to be able to live and be protected with inalienable rights that I believe are God-given, Charlie, and I believe that those are the rights to life and liberty and the pursuit of happiness. That, in my worldview, is the grand plan.
But then are you sending your son on a task that is from God?
I don't know if the task is from God, Charlie. What I know is that my son has made a decision. I am so proud of his independent and strong decision he has made. What he decided to do in serving for the right reasons, in serving something greater than self, and not choosing a real easy path where he could be more comfortable and certainly safer.
And that is world news for this Thursday from Fairbanks, Alaska. As you heard a moment ago, you can see more of this interview today with Governor Sarah Palin later on Nightline. And tomorrow, as I mentioned, we will interview the governor again, this time in her hometown of Wasilla. And we're going to be talking about domestic issues and her record as mayor and governor.
You said recently in your old church, our national leaders are sending U.S. soldiers on a task that is from God. Are we fighting a holy war?
You know, I don't know if that was my exact quote.
Exact words.
Exact words? Technically, yes, except Gibson conveniently either neglected or didn't know that Palin had clearly asked that we pray that our soldiers are on a task from God.
Lies, lies, you're telling me that you'll be true. Lies, lies, that's all I ever get from you.
How about, in honor of the American soldier, you quit making things up.